Hi, it's Greg from Tabletop Nights. Welcome back to Operation Fidget, Mission 1 from Reichbusters from Mythic Games. I did get a couple of things not quite right in our first playthrough, which was room awareness and enemy patrols, but I think I've got that pretty good now. So thanks for bearing with us and sticking with the team. We try and get our quality as high as possible. So if we get it wrong, please let us know, and we like to look at getting things right. So thanks to Carlos Belvis for pointing out a couple of things as well. So I'm going to kick off with my good mate Quentin, who's Mr. Stealthy. He's going to open this door. It does say on page 7 of the rules that noise happens after the action. It's quite explicit. So I'm going to open the door, which immediately spawns these guys. So we have, A is an officer. Ooh, he's going to be terrified. And that room becomes suspicious. Because we're in line of sight, that's why. Now I need to roll for the door, which is a one noise room. I'm going to re-roll that because he's got Quentin has stealthy, which means he can re-roll non-attack or non-weapon noises. So it's a two. Put that there. It says discard two cards or add two dice to your total. Wow, discard two cards already. Crikey. I'm not going to discard any cards. I'm going to add two more dice. That's a six. Doesn't hit the threshold of seven, so we're okay. See, that's how you do it. Quentin is now going to use his pretty little precise bow. So it's a three-range weapon with two dice, and it's silent, and it's precise. Precise means that blanks can be ones. So again, this is his second basic action, because the first was to open the door. The second is to actually fire the bow. It's too early to be using too many cards, so I'm just going to do two dice. So the star explodes, and I can re-roll this one. That still only makes three, so that's not sufficient. Thanks, Quentin. He's not going to do anything else, though. I'm going to end his turn right there. So this room now becomes alert. I think I'll go to Claudine now. So she has the skill Vengeance, which means she can move once for free per turn if it puts her into melee, which she will do. So at the moment, she's had no actions. Now she's going to do an attack on this guy, but first we now have to spawn these people who are now in line of sight. So again, that's a little green one, which is two bees, which is two soldiers. They are also now alert because they take on the awareness of the room. Claudine. So she has a precise knife, which, like the bow, means the blanks can turn to ones. Right now, she's just going to have a basic attack at the officer. Now, if he was in the same area as the guards, she'd have to go for them first. But he's in a different area. So that's three. The blank can become a one due to precise. Where's the one? So he's gone. Officer only has a defense of four. It actually has a defense of three, so I didn't even need to change that other one. So no noise made there so far. So all we've had so far is one basic attack. So now she'll do a basic move. So that's both her basic moves. And you tend to forget. So what I tend to do is go, I take the token for the right person. I sort of put it on its side after I've done one action, and then I flip it to the other side when I've done both basic actions. You can do as many card plays as you want in a turn. So she's going to do, she's a leader. Thanks, Tom Jones. So make a plus two lethal melee attack on two enemy units. So lethal means that blanks can be re-rolled on red and black dice. So again, it's no noise. It's a melee attack. So she gets to roll four dice. Now, if we'd had one more guy in there, she could have cleared four from the room to pacify it, and she would have got a heroic point. But unfortunately, there was only three. So there's a star. We need four to kill soldiers. That's enough to kill one. And now we do the other attack. Again, there's a star. And an extra die, nothing. But he's done as well. So as I killed off the first dude, I should have put a clear token there and a clear token there. The room is now back to totally unaware of what's going on. So that's those two. Let's do Sarge. Sarge will go next. He will do a basic move into here. And we'll attempt to open the door. Well, he will open the door. He doesn't need to attempt. These guys spawn. That's a B and a C, which is again two soldiers. They're immediately suspicious. But I still have to now roll for the noise. Oops. The reason I do it in that order, because it says in the rules that it's after the action, is because you don't want an enemy patrol necessarily spawning in here. It should be spawning behind the nearest closed door, which would be here. So if I didn't open the door first, they'd all be sitting in here, and I don't think that's correct. So that's a star, roll again. Another star, great. Roll again, Sarge, this is a noisy door. Another star, roll again. This is what burst does when you're firing. Another star, so that's four stars, keep going. Have you ever seen that before? So that's eight. Eight noise. I don't think we're gonna be not hitting that threshold. We could re-roll the die, but it's not going to make any difference. So an enemy patrol appears, and it is at ease. So this is what I was talking about. If I hadn't have, if I'd done the noise roll before opening the door, they'd appear here. They should actually appear here. That's my theory, and that's what I'm sticking to. So two greens appearing at ease. So they're going to be at ease, so there'll be no awareness there. So we spawn one. Let's do one first. A and a B, so that's an officer and a soldier. Officer and a gentleman. And the other one is a B and a D. I should have my other glasses on. So that's a soldier and a dog. They're all at ease, but this little troop here, now they're on patrol. So they open this door and they move in. So what I didn't want to do was have them appear here and move into there. I don't think that's the correct way to play it. Now, this door's just opened, so they don't have line of sight to us, so I'm not going to spawn that yet. So these guys that were at ease are now suspicious because they take on the awareness of the room that these guys are in. So that's a whole heap of trouble. Thanks, Sarge. That was great. So Sarge did a move in a door, so he doesn't have any more basic moves. All right, Sarge is going to play I Got This. So each hero on the same or adjacent tile may move one. So, one, two, three. Then make two plus one lethal attacks. Now he's going to use his little versatile. What's he going to do? It's a lot of noise. Now we'll try burst. So we have burst here. He's got a weapon. So that's three dice, but it's actually going to be four. With three noise. So I take my three dice, four dice, and I'll show you how burst works if it happens. So we get to make two. So I'm going to aim at the dog first. We can't aim at the officer first because you have to kill off the guards first, but the dogs roll five dice, so I don't want that to happen. So let's do four and hope we get some burst action. Right. So he's using this burst weapon. So what happens is that becomes a two. And we store them up there and then we keep rolling. Now every time you get a star, you would just keep adding. And that one hit can be applied to all the different units. So a dog, because I said I was aiming at the dog, that takes, well, I don't know if burst has to be aimed at a target. Let me just check. Yep, so burst has to be applied to the initial target, and then ancillary targets can cop it after that. So I actually scored, what did I get? 6-8. Alright, so that's not enough to kill more than the dog at the moment, but each other hero can add modifiers to my attack after the roll. So I'm just going to check what the other dudes have and dudettes. So I'm going to use this one. So Quentin's going to add this one into the mix. So that's another burst. So what will happen is that's a 2, and then I can re-roll. That's a 3. This is how burst works. Now, has anyone else got a... because we're all on the same thing. Here's another star. So this one's from Red Hawk. So she's added one in. So that's another 2, and I can re-roll one. And I need to get my spare pack of dice here. All right, so after Red Hawk's and Quentin's adjustments, I'll just see if Claudine has anything. Claudine can actually add, let's go crazy. So Claudine can add 2 dice to the roll, which the, again, these can be added later. So that's everyone that can contribute one, because we're all in the same space. So I'm gonna roll 2 more. And that's it. So I end up with 2, 4, 6, 7, 10, 15, 18. That's how burst works. So I've added up all those things together, but that was still my first lethal attack. So that's 18. So the dog is 5. So that leaves 13. That's 3 more soldiers. And that leaves 1. 1 point left. Now, with my second lethal attack, if I can clear these guys out, that's going to be an heroic point. So, but I still need to roll the 3 noise for that attack. And 3 noise for all of that is pretty good, I'm thinking. Oh, but I haven't made this. No, sorry, I don't need to roll the noise yet because I get to make my second plus 1 lethal attack. So again, I'm going to use... same weapon, burst. Why not? So that's 3, 4 dice. That's 9. So burst didn't happen though. And it's the same attack, so no one else could add anything. So I just get rid of 1 more. So unfortunately, I didn't clear the room with my dude because he's actually done his 2 basic attacks already. Or 2 basic actions already. So he's shit out of luck there. Although, let's have a look. I have also light him up. So this is make a ranged attack and gain plus 1 for each other hero on the same tile as you. So I need to finish off my 3 noise roll from before. So that's 4 noise. 4 noise is discard 1 card or add 1 to your total. Well, I'm going to discard a card so I don't have to, so the threshold doesn't trigger, so no other patrols. Now I do this one, so I make my range attack and gain 1 for each. So that's, my weapon is 3. I might just use my pistol. Let's just use my little pistol this time. So that's 2 dice plus 1 for each other hero, so that's another 3 dice. Boom, 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 boom. Officer is dead. And officers drop gear as well. So he's done that. So I have managed to clear the entire room. So I get a heroic point. So Sarge, well done. You get, he got one that's a shield or an attack one. And they can go back to HQ to help in the next mission. I had to go and get my spare bag of dice when that burst happened. That was good. I'm glad that's on film. Yes, it is on film. Good. So Sarge is done. And now Red Hawk. She will Ooh, is she going to move in? Yeah, she'll move in. Now, by moving in, she's in line of sight of this one here, so that one spawns. Sarge, you were so impressive that time. There's my spawn. So it's a B, B, and an I, which is two soldiers and a scientist. Now, actually, when as soon as this door opened, well, as soon as I went into the line of sight of here, we get to see what's on this desk. So it says, when this area, you may take a basic action to look at the top three cards of the spawn deck, discard one and put the others back on top of the deck in either order. So that's there. These guys are suspicious because they can see me. Crikey, I think I got all that right. There's a lot to do. So Red Hawk has done just a move. And then she's going to do covering fire. So this one here advances the round track by one spot. So that is the noise that will happen instead of her accurate weapon. So the accurate weapon is three dice with two noise, but this happens instead. So if there was a question mark there, you would use the noise on this token. And if there was a number there, you'd use that instead. So after this covering fire, I have to remember to move the round track up. So we're doing pretty well so far. We've cleaned out a heap. Let's make that ranged attack on each unit. So this is covering fire. If I fail to wound, then it stops. So this is, what did I say? Three dice. So let's aim at one of the soldiers first. That star triggers. That star triggers. But actually, I'll just trigger one and I'll get them to drop some gear. One there, because this isn't a burst. Okay, next, so covering fire, I get to keep going because I did wound. So that's bang, that's another wound, and I get to re-roll one. He's gone. So I get to keep going with covering fire. And now the officer's also dead. I did have a star, so I can re-roll to see whether he gets gear. No gear. So we've now also cleared that room. So what did Red Hawk do? She did her move and covering fire. So she's still got one basic action. I think while it's safe, she might just try and pick up that little bit of gear for one noise. So she picks it up and it is a nice little helmet. And then we roll. Oops, roll in the tray. Two. Look at two. Two says re-roll one non-blank. Well, there is only one. It's still a two. Doesn't break the threshold. Well done, Red Hawk. You're a legend. I still can't get over Sarge. That was awesome. Okay, that's the end of that turn. No one there to give me any trouble. So the round tracker moves up. And we start again. So anyone that doesn't have five cards gets to draw a card. There's no hand limit in this game unless you've got five when you're drawing. You can actually collect two cards as a basic action. But you can only do that. Oh, you can actually do that twice in your turn if you want to, if you just want to stock up on cards. Okay. Next. What do we do, kids? Let's do, always like to send Quentin in. So Quentin will do a basic move. He can usually do a plus one move, so I'm going to do that. He's going to use that card and use the bottom section to do a plus one move. So he's actually going to go to here. And he'll use his other action to look at the spawn deck. So what was it? Look at the top three cards which we've got here. So I'm just going to put them as a B, B, and a B, B, B. So at least I know what they are. That's easy. So that's Quentin actually done. He's not going to do anything else because he wants the others to catch up. Sarge is going to draw two cards because I want him to get a movement card. Here we go. So this says, another hero on the same tile may move one, and then you move one. So Claudine will move one, Sarge will move one. Ooh, he's going to play this. Here's the plan. All other heroes on the same tile may draw one non-feat action card from their discard pile. So Red Hawk is going to draw... So it can't be a feat card, so she'll draw Headshot. And Quentin will draw... What's he going to draw? He's going to draw... He can't draw a feat card. Fate card. Feat card. Feat card. Cards for your feet. He's going to draw... Get the move one, draw one card back into his hand. So that's Sarge. He did a move one, another one's move one. Then he's going to do a basic action just to move to there. And he's done. He hasn't gone. Claudine. So Claudine is going to move one and is she going to open the door? No, I've got plenty of rounds left. She'll just draw two cards. And Red Hawk will move in here and draw two cards as well. So that's the end of another round. So, Quentin gets another card. Claudine doesn't. Sarge does. And Red Hawk doesn't. Alright. I think I'm going to have Red Hawk open the door this time. That's a one level door. It's a one noise. It says, discard one heroic point or add two dice to your total. She doesn't have a heroic point, so she's going to add two dice. That's only two, doesn't hit the threshold, so nice. The door has opened, regardless. So we spawn that one. B, little soldier, spawn this one. BB, two soldiers. And spawn the last one. We know that's a BBB, so that's going to be three soldiers. Because we looked at them earlier. No surprise. They are immediately suspicious. So well done, Red Hawk, for opening the door. Now, she has an accurate weapon, so she could shoot past that guy right up to the other end if she wants to. I really want that burst option. No, she's gonna brave it. So she's actually going to run in. She's opened the door. Oh. Ooh. Ah. I don't want to take back and make Claudine go instead because I don't think that's the right thing to do. So. And I don't want to make noise. So she's actually just going to draw two more cards. How's that for outrageous? So these guys become alert. Because it's the end of her turn. Claudine has a burst weapon as well. But that's unreliable, so it can jam as soon as she doesn't spend a star to keep it going. Oh dear. And Sarge has a pineapple, so that's a beautiful grenade. Alright, so it's over to Claudine. Claudine shall use her one turn to use her vengeance to move in there into melee for free. So then she's going to play this one, which allows her to, in either order, move one or make an attack. So she's going to make an attack against this guy first with her knife, which is a two. Boom, gone. Not boom. Slice. Now she's going to do a move. So she's going to move into there. Claudine doesn't care. She's brave. Brave as. Then she still hasn't done a basic. So she will. She's going to make a plus one melee attack on each unit in her area. So it's three dice. Again, there's no noise, there's knife work. Soldier one. Come on, you can do it. No blanks. Ah! But it's precise, so that becomes a one. Whew. One gone. Next guy. That's a three, but it's precise, so that becomes ones. So that's two gone. Next one. Precise, so again, three gone. Again, no noise. Yeah, she's got these little dudes right there. So she still hasn't done a basic. So she's going to play this card, which is move one and draw one. So she's going to move into here. Draw another card. Then she's going to make a melee attack against two enemy units. So again, this is with a knife, so it's only two dice. We've got some boosters we can throw in. Yeah, we've got some boosters there. So that's, again, that blank, because it's precise, becomes that one. That's done. Last one. Done. All right, Claudine, you are awesome. So they're all done. And a heroic point for Claudine. And she got a wild one. So for a shield or attack. Oh, no, that's the... Oh, what is that one? That's the attack one. Sorry, that's the attack one. Well done, Claudine. She cleared out that whole room. That is awesome. Well, I don't think she's still made a basic move. It was vengeance in, move and attack, move and draw. So she hasn't. So she can still try and pick. She can try and pick up that dossier right now, while she picks it up, regardless. Which is awesome. And roll for noise. Two noise. That's a star. Oops. Hang on. Watch out. That's six. Six on the noise brigade. Discard a card, which she will. And then alert enemy units immediately attack. If they cannot attack, they move. This is not an activation. Well, there aren't any at all. So, bad luck. So that's the end of the round. We move the tracker up one. Tokens go back. Quentin gets a card. Claudine gets a card. I could have actually had her move, I think, because I think she still had one left, but that's okay. Red Hawk doesn't get any. All right, so. Sarge. I really should have made her move. So Claudine will actually go first. And no, because I want her to just escape. If she can. Can she? She possibly can. Alright, Sarge. Sarge is going to play that one for a plus one basic move. So he gets to move two. So he gets to go one, two. Then Sarge will actually, yep, he'll now try and open that door. So that's a three noise level door. So this is his second basic move. He's rolled three noise. Three noise is add three dice to the total. Great. One, two, three. So that's 247. Does not hit the threshold. So safe. Well done.
the door's open anyway.
And then Claudine can use plus one basic move to run out the door. So take that, boys. I'm out of here. So look, I tried to sprint through as fast as I could. I think that was about four rounds. I think I've got most of it right. It looked pretty right. It felt right. I think the enemy patrols are there. We'll see how we go. Please leave your comments. Hope you liked that. Feel free to subscribe. Join in for more Reichbusters or what else you want to see. The more I play it, the less it feels like Zombicide. I think it's a different experience. And once we get into the deeper missions, and this is still just a learning mission, and there's still a fair amount of intensity in it. So I really enjoyed that. Hope you did too. We'll talk to you soon. Cheers.